Hey Fishheads, I'm Jason Hallicker.
And I'm John Odenkirk.
And today we're on the Rappahannock River and we're conducting an electrofishing survey, but this is no ordinary survey, is it, John?
No, this is not your ordinary electrofishing survey. Typically in a normal electrofishing survey, we got one boat and we're out here in the fall and we run up the river and we do a quick survey and pick up what we can get. That gives us a relative abundance metric on these fish. Now we've got every boat in the state that's available to us. Theoretically, we're supposed to have 17 boats on this stretch of river because it's so wide, and we've got 15 out here today, and we're going up in a depletion. We're actually going to take all the fish out on the first run and hold them back, the second run, the third run, and that way we get some real numbers in biomass and population estimates about how many of each species of fish are in this section of river. This is a pretty novel concept. Back about 10 or 15 years ago, it was applied a lot in trout streams with backpack shockers, but nobody had ever tried to do this sort of depletion electrofishing on a river as big as this, as Rappahannock River in Fredericksburg.
My name is Kaylee Johnson, and I'm a natural resource specialist. So once we collect the fish, they're put into tubs and distributed at each of the stations. And at each of the stations, we identify the fish, we weigh the fish and measure the fish. And then the fish are taken to the bass buggy because our main goal is to have them happy and healthy so they can be released afterwards.
CCF 254.
After the fish are worked up, they can't be released back into the river. Otherwise, we'd catch the same fish twice and that would totally mess up our population estimate. Yep. That's where the bass buggy comes into play. The bass buggy works by pumping fresh water from the river. Each tub has its own inlet and outlet, creating a flow-through system. We also have oxygen for each tank. So even though the fish aren't real happy with us, the bass buggy keeps them healthy while they wait patiently for us to complete the depletion.
We've spent the whole week on the Rappahannock River at different sites. We started further upstream and now we're down close to the tidal section. And what we've learned is that the diversity is amazing in this river. It looks fantastic. And what is so cool is that we've got fish like striped bass and yellow perch and white perch and long-nosed gar, the fish that migrate from way down, you know, below Fredericksburg, and now they're using the habitat that's available to them that were denied access for over 100 years because of Embry Dam. And so not only have we seen how good the sunfish community is, like the smallmouth and the redbreast, and that's a lot of biomass, but we're seeing huge numbers of channel catfish. Never had channel catfish before Embry Dam came down. Now that's a naturalized fish. It's not technically native. People think they are because they've been here since the 1800s. But those fish are everywhere in this river, and it's so much. It's a good recreational fishery, and it's a great food fish. So we encourage people to come out, catch some catfish on the Rappahannock River, and enjoy them. There's a bunch of fish here.
Yeah, as you can see, this is an incredible resource. You're definitely going to want to come out and check out this river and grab a rod and reel and fish it this fall.
Fishing should be fantastic.
Absolutely. For more information, you can go on our website and go on the Rappahannock River page. And just remember to go outdoors. Virginia, thanks for watching.